Charles. We've been doing various demonstrations all over the place in Tameside, Manchester. And we're quite good at doing them. You know, we get numbers. But my daughter here got sanctioned when she was 23 weeks pregnant. She was told that she had to go for a workfare interview at B&Q, work for nothing. Right. She went for the interview. She came to the back to the job centre, and the job centre said, "Oh, I'm sorry, we're sanctioning you because you told them you were pregnant." B&Q saw she was pregnant. She was 23 weeks pregnant, and the baby was quite big.
So she's essentially been sanctioned for being pregnant?
Yes, she was sanctioned for being pregnant. She was also, it's an illegal sanction, and she was sanctioned for being honest as well.
Right.
For not breaking the law. These broke the law in giving her that sanction, yet they will not admit it. They're not held responsible to anyone. But then as we've been standing out here, we did a couple out here in her honour, and as we were standing outside here, we decided, hang on, what's going on here? Well, in 1 week, 3 pregnant women came out sanctioned. In 1 week, that is one day, like a Thursday. And we said, this isn't right. So we kept coming back. Because it's a matter of importance that we actually make the job centre answerable for their crimes.
Yeah.
We need to hold Ashton Lyne Job Centre and every job centre in the country answerable for their crimes against humanity. A man froze to death in the streets the other week. Because he had substance problems, but he was sanctioned by this job centre. If he hadn't been sanctioned, he might have had a bed for the night.
Yeah.
You know, you get sanctioned, your housing benefit stops, everything stops. So wherever he was staying, if I'd been at a local place, he would have been kicked out of. He was on the streets of froze to death. And that's what made me want to do a memorial service today. It's really important that we actually honour the people that have passed away as a result of this government's actions and of this job centre's actions. If it wasn't for me, my daughter would have starved.
Yeah.
She would have done. She had no gas, no electric, no food, absolutely nothing. And she was 23 weeks pregnant. And that upsets me now, because that baby was born 5 weeks early because of the stress that she was under. Of course, I'll never admit it, but we know it's true and we know it's happening. Last week, we was outside and another pregnant lady had been sanctioned. Why hadn't she been sanctioned? Because she'd not received a letter from them about a meeting. The letter had never been sent out. But they're not answerable to anybody.
No.
This is what I'm calling upon the UK government to start being answerable for their crimes against humanity.
They are our servants, after all.
They work for us.
Yes.
That building is our building, yet we're barred from that building.
Yep.
We paid for that building. They're public servants.
Yep.
You know, but they need to remember this, and they need to remember that we are going nowhere, absolutely nowhere, until these crimes stop. We were asked the other week how long you're going to be standing outside here for, and I said we're going to be standing outside here for as long as they sanction people. As long as if one person dies, that's one person too many. If one person is sanctioned, that is one person too many. Why should they have the right to tell someone if they live or if they die? Because when they hand the sanction out, that is exactly what happens.
Yep.
They are telling that person whether they can live, whether they can die. Whether the children can eat, whether the children can't eat. Why is that right?
They're walking on water.
It isn't right. It isn't right, is it? So that is why we're here, and this is why we'll continue to be here. You know, and we are peaceful. They're the ones that are peaceful. We've had them threatening us. G4S has threatened to knock us out. Me and two women. You know what I mean? Another woman, sorry. They threatened to knock us out. Why is that right? And they weren't answerable to that. They won't give any details so we can make complaints. So the woman's had to take it further.
Cowards.
Cowards, absolute cowards, but I'm old, I want it. This is a message for David Cameron, and this is a message for Ian Duncan Smith, who loves this job centre. He came to visit, he's been here more than once, but he's hid. I want to meet him, and I want to talk to him about this. I looked up 5 minutes
ago. A certain number of sanctions.
You must get a certain number of sanctions. How is that in any way humane?
It's not.
It doesn't matter who it is or what the circumstances are. Just make sure you get a certain number of sanctions. So these guys are under pressure to take people's food. Take people's food out of their mouth. So they can't feed the kids. They can't heat the home.
Yeah.
What kind of insane society do we live in?
We do live in an insane society.
It's completely insane, and it's about time everybody knew. It's about time everybody woke up.
A woman last week came out. She was so upset and frustrated. She was screaming, and she just was a wild mannered, ordinary kind of woman. We know that they've been told to aggravate people in order to sanction them, literally. So that's why we're here every week.
Right. So what you're saying is they're deliberately being provocative to get people to react in a sort of violent manner.
Absolutely.
Okay. And terrible.
Isle of Ashton. We're standing here because we're concerned for the state of our country today. I'm standing here as a priest who's fed up of doing funerals of people who have been burdened down by some of the pressures the vulnerable people of our society are facing. We're here not because we're against the staff who are working here, but because we're concerned at the pressures on them to sanction people to such a degree that they're so impoverished, some of them are committing suicide. This needs to stop. It's wrong. And it would appear that because there is no obvious murderer, people are trying their best to simply ride through it. Some of the staff in here we know are under a lot of pressure themselves, and they're sick that the job they came into to do good for people has turned into what it is. We're going to shortly hear a list of the names of those who have died because of the attack, and it is an attack on the poor by the people with power who have let the bankers and the criminals at the top of the hierarchy off scot-free. We're looking for another way to be human, a way where we all work together for everyone and everybody is lifted up. So thank you for listening, and may you have a wonderful season of light, whether it's Hanukkah, Christmas or Diwali. Please use this time to think about how we need to approach being human together in the new year.
To the sound of music, no.